Hello and welcome to the Noshing with Nina show. I'm your host, Nina Kennedy. And today we have with us the rock ballerina, Kimberly Nicole. We're so happy to have you with us today.
It's my pleasure, my pleasure.
Welcome, welcome. You're just literally getting off the plane
from
London.
Yes.
Wow.
Not jet lag, I'm fine.
Yeah,
but
good for you.
I'm glad you guys asked me to be here, thank you.
Well, so glad you could come. If you fall over, I'll understand. Because it's happened to me, just getting
Girl.
Off the plane.
Yes.
Not getting any sleep and all
Absolutely,
of that.
Absolutely, yes.
So we saw your performance at the Sugar Bar, Ashford & Simpson mm-hmm. Sugar Bar, right before you left for your Blaxit.
Yes. Blacks and I love it. Yes, absolutely.
And it was absolutely fabulous.
Thank you.
Fabulous. How did that?
You guys wrote about it too.
That's right. Mm-hmm. We blogged about it. Had to give you a plug.
Yeah.
Now you've known Ashford & Simpson for a while, right? How did that relationship start out?
Well, I moved to New York in 2008, and I remember I was really trying to start my career here as a musician, and I knew friends here. And there are specific places they would tell me to go. They say, go to the Village Underground and go to Ashford & Simpson's Sugar Bar. Mm-hmm. And I was like, Ashford & Simpson? I'm like, you talking about Nick and Val? My friend's like, yeah, girl, that's a bar they own. You should go there and sing. So I went there one night. God, it had to be when I first moved here, moved to Harlem. Went to their bar on the Upper West Side on 72nd Street. And then I got up and I put my name on this list. You know, nobody knew who I was. You know, it's sometimes an older and younger crowd, and they kind of look at you like, you know how the New Yorkers are. You gotta, mm-hmm. you gotta prove yourself.
Right.
So I was like, I put my name on this list, and I waited around to get up and sing. I got up and sang, and Nick and Val were singing background on the mic.
Oh, wow.
And I was like, I was kind of freaked out because I'm like, these are like icons, legends to me, because I remember growing up, my parents are Motown era kids. They always talked about Motown, and I knew their discography of Motown songs, but I also knew them as solid as a rock. Mm-hmm. So I was like, I'm sitting here looking at Nick, who's basically was the black Jesus, if we always want to be honest. And then I'm looking at Val, and they're singing background with me, this little unknown girl, and they're just there, like in real life. So I was really overwhelmed with my having this access to these greats, not just black greats, but just greats beyond with the music of the world, how they've written all this music that has stuck with all people for generations. Yeah. And I couldn't believe they were just sitting there. I remember calling my dad, I'm like, Daddy, I left this place called the Sugar Bar. It's owned by Ashford & Simpson. He was like, Ashford & Simpson? I said, yes, Daddy, they were there, solid as a rock. He said, solid as a rock? Ashford said, yes, Daddy. They were sitting there, the black Jesus, and his wife was there singing with me, and I'm really a little overwhelmed. So they took a liking to me because they saw something that was very special, and they helped me as much as they could along my career. I called them my musical fairy godparents.
Such sweet people.
Yeah, beautiful people.
Really.
Nick is gone, but Valerie, she'll be at the show on Saturday. Like, they have been rooting for me forever.
Yeah.
Good people.
Yeah, really, really love
just
them.
Just regular. I remember Val one time, someone was like, hey, can you take a picture of me and Val? Val was like, she doesn't take pictures of four people. She's a star. I was like,
already.
I said, well, mama's teaching me. You know, when the black divas start teaching you, you learn. You pick it up. So, all right, mom, you're right. I don't take pictures for anybody anymore.